Those Jurassic Park toys.
Did you see the trailer for Jurassic World, by the way?
I have not yet, no. I've heard... I've heard good things about it.
It looks like it could be awesome. But it also looks like it could be really stupid. So, I'm not sure yet. I have high hopes, because it at least looks better than anything I've seen in a while. It looks like it could definitely be better than the last two sequels. And this is like the only time I think in my life where I was actually happy to not see an actor come back from the original. Because I think that's kind of one of the things that bothers me in the sequels, is I just can't wrap my head around the fact that, especially in the third one, is like I can't wrap my head around the fact that Grant's back there. I think they drug him or something, but it's still, I'm just like, why would he even get involved? Why do you need him to go back there? It's like, why'd you need Malcolm to go back there in Lost World? It just, I don't know.
Yeah, that was a little sketchy. Apparently the Asian guy from the first pack is coming for Jurassic World. Grant could be digging up bones for Jurassic Park.
I don't think anybody who went to that park in the first movie would want to go back there.
You burned to death.
As in the main four characters, anyways. You know. And hey, it's the only movie where you can see, Samuel L. Jackson be a computer nerd.
I think you might be right about that.
Hold on to your butts!
So wait, hold the phone. That little doodad utility gremlin thing, that thing is immune to sludge?
Easy, boy.
Hello?
What? No, he's not. Sorry. I was got distracted. Yeah, let's see. I forgot what I was gonna say now. But yeah, I love Jurassic Park 1. I wasn't a fan of either of the sequels.
Wait, hold the phone. Samuel L. Jackson's dead?
No, he's not. But his character died.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Samuel L. Jackson's still alive.
I misunderstood what WJ was talking about. I was like, wait, when did that happen?
I'd be really upset if that was a cat. If that was the case. But yeah. Samuel L. Jackson is a computer nerd. Who'd have thunk that?
Not many people, I wouldn't think.
In fact, he's like the only thing... probably the only good thing... or the only thing that remotely interests me in the new RoboCop movie, and from what I hear, he even sounds like he's bored in that movie.
I wouldn't doubt that. That new RoboCop movie looks terrible.
From my understanding, they completely missed the point.
They completely missed the goddamn... It's like, you want to talk about missing the point? I don't know, have you ever played or heard of Wacky Funsters for the computer? Like an old MS-DOS game?
No, aren't you playing that recently or something like that?
I posted the CD soundtrack exclusively to my channel on YouTube recently. And I am the only one who has that, apparently. Because it has not been posted to YouTube ever.
Cool. So,
that, and I posted Geekwad Games of the Galaxy as well. But anyway, speaking of missing the point... some guy did a review of Wacky Funsters, the game, and they were harping on it left and right, saying that it's garbage, the games are garbage, they're just cheap knockoffs of this and that, and blah blah. And all the while I'm watching this review, I'm like thinking to myself, that's the point, you dummy! It's satire, it's a parody. The game itself, the instruction manual, the back of the box, everything about it says, yeah, we're just having fun. because that's what people, that's what software programmers and whatnot did in the 90s. They made, some of them made serious games, most of them just had a lot of fun.
Yep.
Like, even, I even said, you know, even Wolfenstein 3D, as serious a game as that was, that had a lot of fun to it. And it didn't, it, well, actually, it didn't take itself that seriously. I mean, Mecha Hitler?
Well, isn't there also a section where you get chased by Pac-Man, or reference to Pac-Man?
There is. There is a literal Pac-Man level in, what was it? Episode 3, I think it was. You go through a Pac-Man maze collecting all sorts of, you know, like chalices, gold chests, etc., and the Pac-Man ghosts are there. I think they're the only episodes in that, the only enemies in that level, too. Hey, kid, are you okay? Uh-huh. So, I mean, yeah, that's what people did back then. They made fun games. Sometimes they were serious efforts, you know what? I can't think of one. Because, I mean, like, ZZT, Jill of the Jungle, Jazz Jackrabbit, Hocus Pocus, Mystic Towers, those were all goofy-ass games, but they were solid games, too.
Cosmos Cosmic Adventure, or whatever. Cosmic Caper.
Cosmo Caper?
Yeah, Cosmos Cosmic Caper, or something.
Oh, well, Cosmos Cosmic Adventure. Yeah. That was also... You know, actually, that might have been one of the more serious goofy games. Oh yeah, King's Quest. Those were, well, even King's Quest had fun because it had, like, you know, Grimm's Fairy Tale stuff in it.
Yeah.
But it wasn't explicitly the programmers poking fun at, actually, come to think of it, the Robertas did like to poke fun at a lot of things in King's Quest.
Yep. Though, I have to say, for a female, Roberta Williams does not seem to have a very high opinion of her gender.
Yeah. That thing from the cutting room floor from King's Quest 2.
Just that and King's Quest 6, the fact that Queen What's-Her-Face has, like, a freaking item to make her cry to solve puzzles.
That was King's Quest 7. Look. Wrong outfit.
Yes, you're right. Yeah, King's Quest 7. 6 is the one where you're playing Alexander.
Yeah. King's Quest 7, that was something else.
And or any of the Phantasmagoria games.
Really? Are they really gender biased?
Yeah.
I've never played or watched anybody play Phantasmagoria.
I've
heard they're really good games, though.
The first one isn't. Ooh. Because Slow Beef and someone else actually do a wrong parade of it, and it's... Ugh.
Huh. I'm going to have to look into that. That's right. Slow Beef and the head of something awful. I forget his name.
But yeah, right? I don't remember. They're... I was watching it, and I was like, good God, Roberta Williams, you just have no faith in your own gender?
Nice. Phantasmagoria, a feast of flesh.
Yeah, Slow Beef and Low Tax.
Low Tax, thank you, Solar Flare. Oh, hey. DJ Paradroid just explained the hologram thing.
Oh.
It's a digital scan that was taken before you changed your costume and is stored in the communicator.
Well, that would Boom. Make sense.
I mean, that's probably not... That's probably more thought than they put into it, but, you know.
I'll buy it. I'll buy that for a dollar.
I'd buy that for a dollar.
The sad thing is some people remember that more as being in Smash TV than in RoboCop.
You know, I think that's actually where I first heard it. But that has been an occasional thing that I've said ever since, so...
But from what I've all the reviews I've heard of the new RoboCop movie, the show that they missed the point, like, Michael Keaton's playing the villain, but he's playing it practically as, like, a freaking cartoon character. Like, one of those over-the-top, like, 80s cartoon bad guys.
Big Boss.
Yeah.
Generic Big Boss kind of guy.
Yeah, and just really just hamming it up and over-the-top, and it's like, no, that's... It's like, they understood that there was comedic elements, but... Not that it was a satire.
Yeah, I mean, Joe Pesci, when he played the... No, that wasn't Joe Pesci. That was Red Foreman. Or the guy who played Red Foreman. Excuse me. I got my villains confused. But that guy, when he did that villain in RoboCop, he was actually a serious villain.
Yep.
And an asshole to boot.
Oh, heck yeah.